Hello, my name's Jason, and welcome to another very exciting episode of me painting again. And today we're going to be doing a painting of this onion. This is actually a picture I took of an onion, and I liked it. It's actually of an onion that's on its way out, to be fair. So I had a bag of onions, and this one didn't get used. So its fate was not to go in a lasagna or a bolognese or anything like that. Its fate was to have its picture taken and be famous and be a famous onion. So let's have a go at painting it, and I'll see what I can do. And I'm going to use one of these as well, these squares, just so I can measure it when I'm drawing. All like that, and I'm using the Artisan Water Mixable Oil color range, Winsor & Newton Artisan paints. They are oil paints that can be thinned with a little bit of water because of the science of the linseed oil they use, which I don't know how they do it, but they do. So here we have the picture. So the first thing is we need to draw the onion. Basically, it's pretty simple, isn't it? We need to get that onion shape. Now we could just paint straight on the canvas, or we could draw it on the canvas, or we could trace it onto the canvas. So many different ways to start painting. Wow, did that used to annoy me when I first started, because I had no idea how to start a picture, and I found it pretty frustrating, to be honest. So, anywho, I think the best way for us is to have a very thin, very thin, it's the way I'm going to do it anyway, very thin crimson, very thin amount of crimson, and using my little ruler. So we have about 12 and a half at its widest, so beep and beep. So grab the onion about there, and shape of it is sort of round. Well, it's pretty round, isn't it? It is an onion, they are round. It sort of it hits the table there and goes around there. Some water to my colour. It's around, creating a shape like that. Something like that, anyway. I'm not too fussed if I don't get it exact, to be honest. As long as it looks like an onion at the end of the day. And then got that bit that comes out there. Something like that. Just sit back, have a look. Sitting back, having a look. Always sitting back, having a look. Like the t-shirt. Sitting back having a look. If you've not seen the t-shirt yet, I've created a t-shirt I can wear to remind myself to sitting back having a look. Just to remind myself to do that. And it's fun to have a t-shirt that supports this channel as well. So here we go, there's an onion. Something like that. And you can modify the shape of it if you wish. If it's not quite right, then you can change it. You can use a ruler to get it perfect. You can do all sorts of things to really work out your picture. But I think that'll do as a starting block, to be honest. So What I need to do is get this dark color next, and it is really dark. So to me, actually, let's put some black out. Black. So I've laminated my picture that I took of the onion, and that way you can put your paint actually on it. So, obviously black is too black. It's too dark, look, you can tell straight away. So, I would say we could use a little bit crimson in with the black. That and still it's a touch too dark, so we need some white. Ooh. Some white, put some there. So we've got plenty to use. So I've been doing a few acrylic paintings recently. It's kind of good not having to stress so much about the paint drying. I know you're gonna say, why don't you get a stay wet palette? You might be right, it probably is the answer. But I kind of like using my old tray. So there we go, got sort of a greyish color, and we've actually gone slightly too light, just slightly. Then too dark. Too light, too dark, too light, too dark. So we only want to get it pretty close anyway. So it's not crimson enough either. Well, that's pretty close to that area, like there. Which when you put it on, you're like, whoa, that's dark. Yeah, it is pretty close for that area. So let's put it in. Of course, we can modify things as we go. Something like that. That dark bit underneath here. Going around. Something I was thinking about when I thought, oh, I'll paint an onion. When you learn something, you have to know it, don't you? You have to know your onions. That made me think about painting an onion. To know the onion. So there's actually a little bit of a little bit of the skin that's come away there. Just creating the shape here, bringing that into that. Into this onion. Unless, yeah, there's a sort of a bit of skin, so I need to go into a lighter colour and put some of this skin here. That's actually a bit too light, to be honest. It's not tinted red enough. Must have crimson in this. Let's keep the crimson in, keep it real. Like I said, this won't be an exact replica of that onion. It's just a just to show you how to achieve something like this. Really? Okay, just sitting back having a look. Yeah, I quite like this so far. It's looking oniony. Looks like there needs to be a bit more crimson in places, like in this area here. Crimsony coming into this as well. I want to get that sort of a lightishness to that area. Sort of. A little bit of light here as well, so that's some of this. So far I've just used black and the crimson, so I need to think about this area now. I want more crimson. I think before I start throwing that in, I might start putting some colour in here as well, so the transition isn't quite as harsh. Sitting back, having a look. Now let's have a look at this area. So mine is slightly too red. So let's get some black actually. Nice brush. I'd say that has gone a bit too red as well. So let's. Dull that down a little bit. Okay, so let's get some blue, some of the ultramarine blue. Just wipe this brush. Just gonna wipe. Now we want our crimson and our blue. Crimson and blue. Crimson and blue. And white. So what colour we make? Yeah, that's pretty close there. Right there. Pretty close along here. And there's some of this over here as well. There's a bit more red in it over here. I can put that in. So back into this colour, get some more white. Let's see if we can make that lighter colour. Probably needs a bit more blue in this, but let's have a look anyway. Put it in. So it's quite light. Yeah, it's just not quite there. Bit more blue. It's pretty close. Looks like a tiny bit more blue there. Yeah, that's very close now. It does always amaze me when I'm mixing colours and then put it up to it and see what it looks like. And I always think, wow, that looks so different to what I was expecting it to be. especially when I'm making greens, I'm like, wow, there's so many different greens. Just gonna make this colour slightly more blue in it. It's about right now. Sort of bring these colours together. Okay, just sit back. Have a look at that. It's a bit more light I see on this bit here. Okay, I want to create the colour of that now. Pretty close to this. Now it goes into more of a bluish. Something like that. Okay, now then, let's get some more white in this colour. This blue. A bit more white. Definitely more blue. I'll do. It's a need some colour in there. More in here. Okay, I need a thinner brush. Should we do the background first before we go too crazy? Let's do this bit there. It's like a blue and black, isn't it? Blue and black, blue and black. It sort of goes. Put that in. I do enjoy doing paintings like this. Enjoy mixing the colours. It's good practice, isn't it? For that, and I want to make this colour so it's sort of a greyish with a bit of. I've made a colour like that before. It's quite good actually. When you've done a few pictures, you start remembering colour mixtures and you think, oh yeah, I made that colour, I know what that colour is. Because I've made that colour, I'm sure it's yellow ochre and black. White. Let's try it anyway. Some ochre. Okay, ochre, black and white. Very similar, just need a bit darker. I'll try and get it quite close. Sort of a little bit more. Put a bit of brown in it. It's very close. Colour in. This goes to about. This is actually, I used this table, and the table is quite, it's quite dirty, it's been outside a while, but I thought it worked quite well, when I took the picture. Break up that colour a little bit by introducing a bit of white in it. There's a tiny more yellow in it over this area. And then it goes a bit dark underneath. Just sit back, have a look. Use that. I'll just throw this colour in everywhere. Around this onion. Good thing about this dull colour, it goes back nicely, so it makes the onion come forward. Just sitting back, always sitting back having a look, always sitting back having a look, always, always, always. So I find when painting in general, if you get the colours right, the job just gets a lot easier, doesn't it? Because when you spend ages, and I've done many a picture and I've spent ages on it, refining it and getting it as right as possible, and then I realise, yeah, the colours aren't right. And I've spent ages on a painting and not really gone into the depth of the colours, and it just doesn't look right. It doesn't look as professional as other people's, and for a while I couldn't understand why my work just wasn't getting to that level, that next level that I was aiming for. I mean, I'm still aiming for it. I'm always aiming to be better. I couldn't understand why my work just wasn't reaching a more professional look. And it was because I wasn't putting enough time and effort into the colour mixing, into really creating the colours of nature. I mean, colour mixing is just something to practice. It's just something you have to practice and get better at it. Look at the tone, look at the what colour is it that you're after? A bit of thinking. Just notice this is a lot higher than I was painting it. Okay, how are we looking? It's looking a lot better, isn't it? Now we've started to develop it a bit. It's looking a little more oniony. I think it looks like an onion. Okay, now then, let's use a smaller brush. I want to get this area painted, but I don't want to use that big brush because it'll mess things up a bit. I can use it afterwards, after I've take the paint out. And this bit here. We've got some areas there. Okay. Some light blue. So let's go back to the onion. Back to the onion. Know your onions. Let's have a look at this bit here. That bit here. What colour is that? It's sort of this colour. Let's put that in there. And then there's a dark bit. It's quite dark actually there. Let's use another brush. A bit of black, crimson, and a little bit of blue. More blue. And this dark colour, and I can put in these bits as a bit dark there and there. And this bit that sort of comes off. This will work quite well to create shape there. Quite like that. Might use a little bit more of that light colour. Just to do that. More light. Crimson. More crimson. Let's see if we can create this line here. And there's this split as well here. So it goes brown and dots down to there. Wipe my brush, get some more of this crimson on. This crimson. A little bit of blue in with it. A bit of white and blue. Yeah, that's better. So I've got this. putting in a few of these shapes. Want to create that shape a bit cleaner. Okay. Some more of that crimson and create this shape there. Okay, just sitting back, having a look. Okay. That works quite well. Yeah, so I'll go with that for now. Now I need to do a little bit more detail in this area. I need a liner brush. The question is, there it is. So I need these colours, and it's sort of a brown, yellowy brown with white in it. Yellowy brown and white, I think, anyway. Let's have a look at that. Burnt umber, yellow ochre. Burnt umber, yellow ochre. It's almost. A touch of black as well, probably. No, that takes some of it away. You can see by drawing that it's a bit too green. Might put a bit of crimson in with it. Not far off. Touch of black. not far off actually, so let's have a go at putting it in. So I want some of these rooty things. A bit of this dark colour and a few more. Not quite dark enough. A few more of these. A bit of sort of colour there. There's a bit there. I need some while I'm doing this, I can see this needs a bit more dark in it. Something like that, but you can see what you can do here. With a little bit of time, you can paint a bit of an onion. It's good fun. It's fun to do. But yeah. I think for now I'll do for my onion, and I hope you enjoyed this episode. I think this onion is going to live in my kitchen. But yeah, I think that'll do for this video. I enjoyed doing this one. It's a lot of fun, and I hope you give it a go. Have a go at painting a onion or something else, whatever you want to do. It's up to you. So yeah, thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you in another episode. Don't forget to check out my Facebook, or if you'd like to support the channel, check out Patreon, or even check out the link below and get yourself a t-shirt. Sitting back having a look t-shirt. Anyway, thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you in another episode. Cheers, bye.